Hiram and Dr. Dre, we need to talk. Welcome to Rotten Skin, a critical lens to skincare. And when I say critical lens, I do mean a critical lens. Today we're going to talk about two of the most well-known influencers on YouTube in the skincare community who have recommended the use of Dermablend Flawless Creator Drops to tint your own sunscreen at home. And this is me saying that they're wrong. I'm gonna tell you why. Also, it seems that more and more people are interested in information about myself, so I have made note of that, and I asked you all for questions for me to answer in an upcoming video about myself on Instagram. I asked the questions on Instagram. I'm going to make the video on YouTube, if that wasn't clear. Where's my tea? Much better. Where was I? Right, you have been asking me your questions, going to make a video on YouTube. But today, if you stick around and pay attention, I have inserted an Easter egg that has my name in it. So pay attention and you may find it. Don't tell anyone. Also, if you like skincare content, please give me a thumbs up. Thanks. So Dr. Dre first promoted these pigment drops by Dermablend back in April and showed how she mixed them into her CVS sunscreen, which was made out of zinc oxide and octinoxate. It's in a little container. I actually have that sunscreen. It burned me. I'm not gonna use it again. So in both posts, she alludes to some research done by Dermablend that shows that the addition of these drops into sunscreen does not compromise the SPF. And to me, this seemed like a really revolutionary finding, since almost every dermatologist and chemist frowns upon doing this kind of DIY mixing at home.
Dermablend has shown me their studies, industry studies that they performed, doing SPF testing, the MED testing to determine SPF on sunscreens before and after using these. And the SPF is not compromised with these.
The concept that a foundation, which is really what the Dermablend drops are, could be compatible with any sunscreen seemed too good to be true. But it was Dr. Dre promoting this after all, and she's a board certified dermatologist, so she must be right, right? Surely she did her due diligence before promoting this technique. But of course, this being the critical skincare channel that it is, I was wondering, where is the research? I want to see it. It wasn't cited in any of her posts. So further research into the product, the Dermablend Flawless Creator Drops, shows that they have what they call a highly pigmented formula with 33% high performance pigments, whatever that means. But nowhere on their site or marketing do they claim that you can safely mix these drops into sunscreen without compromising the protection. So I thought this was highly suspicious. Why would they pay for a study, find favorable conclusions that could help them move their product, and not promote this technique anywhere on their product website or information? I decided to table it, save it for another day. Maybe the research hadn't been published yet. Maybe it was, who knows? But then several months later, Hiram put out a YouTube video and also a TikTok where he showed that a minimal amount of this foundation could be used to effectively tint sunscreen just directly on the hand. In his morning routine, he discusses a clinical study done by Dermablend that shows no adverse reaction when mixed with sunscreen, and also goes on to state that they actually find that it enhances the UV protection of sunscreen when mixed in.
But they've done clinical tests on this one and found that not only does it not affect the sunscreen protection, it also, it enhances it, it makes it better.
But then a few weeks later, Hiram came out with another YouTube video, which was a sponsorship between CeraVe and Dermablend. And here there was a stronger suggestion of mixing in the Dermablend drops with the CeraVe hydrating SPF 30 sunscreen. In the video, he notes that Dermablend
and CeraVe teamed up to sponsor this video because they love this mixing technique between their products.
So at this point, I had already learned that Dermablend was a L'Oreal company as well as CeraVe, so I thought it was really odd that these were being identified as two different sponsors when in fact they all operate under the same parent corporation. It was becoming even more suspicious that the only place I could find the suggestion to mix it into sunscreen was on these two influencers' posts, which were presumably sponsored. So again, searched far and wide to find this study. It had been several months after Dr. Dre's post at this point, to no avail. All I could find was a study done by L'Oreal's pigmentation clinic where they did use the Dermablend drops. Already alluded to this earlier, they showed that they can provide effective visible light protection. In this study, they compared the Dermablend drops to a regular SPF from Banana Boat, and they did not mix the drops into sunscreen whatsoever. I decided to reach out to the source directly because I could not find any information on my own, and on the Dermablend contact site, page, whatever you want to call it, I messaged them and I asked, hey, I saw two influencers state that you can mix your Dermablend Flawless Creator Drops into a mineral sunscreen. They cite some research that was done. Can you please show me the research? This is the response I got maybe a week after that inquiry. Thank you for contacting Dermablend. Flawless Creator is a lightweight liquid foundation. We have not tested this product when mixed into a mineral sunscreen. We suggest applying the mineral sunscreen first, followed by Flawless Creator. We hope this information is helpful. Thank you again for contacting us. This was sent directly from their customer care service center. And thus my initial suspicions and concerns were confirmed. There are no studies showing its compatibility with mineral sunscreens, and presumably none showing its compatibility with any sunscreen. So let's say that the customer service center got it wrong. There's always a chance that could happen. Even if there was a study where Dermablend mixed these drops into a sunscreen, let's say it's a mineral sunscreen, how can you then say that those results can be extrapolated to every sunscreen on the planet? It's a very far reach, and it's why I was suspicious from the get-go. Studies like that don't happen. It'd be a really risky conclusion to make. Every sunscreen formulation is different and thus could be impacted in varying ways by even just a tiny amount of something like a foundation. And again, most dermatologists and chemists across the board agree that you should not alter your SPF in any way. The best case scenario is you will end up diluting the SPF because you're adding something to the product, thus reducing the concentration of SPF. But more likely though, the addition of something like foundation will end up compromising the film that's created by the sunscreen, thus creating uneven coverage across the area you apply it to. So I found a really good article that showed several expert opinions in a Q&A kind of format. And so I wanted to point those out because I think that really helps round out this conclusion that I made. So the International Scientific Communications Director at Clarins, who also has a doctorate in pharmacy, was a scientific communication director at Chanel, and Johnson & Johnson said, when it's a matter of mineral filters, they're powder. If you cut the homogeneity of the formula, you will have holes in the protection on your skin. In our labs, we check the perfect homogeneity of a product to make it not so whitish and not so visible, but it's very complicated to make sure the consumer has a very homogeneous and protective formula. If you blend in whatever, you don't have a homogeneous film over the skin, so all the UV rays can enter. The Senior Associate Director of Global Sun Care Formulation Development at Bayer, who makes Coppertone, states that you start messing with the sunscreen film and you start getting unpredictable consequences. In general, things that modify the film will modify the SPF unpredictably. The general recommendation for sunscreen application and makeup is to apply a sunscreen that you like, wait for it to dry, and apply your product on top. This is completely in alignment with what Dermablend's customer care sent to me. Their recommendation for using their drops on top of sunscreen is to layer them, allow the mineral sunscreen underneath to dry, and then apply the makeup on top. And finally, a dermatologist and co-founder of Compass Dermatology in Toronto states that basically, if you add anything, it's no longer a sunscreen. You can't guarantee its effectiveness if you dilute it with other things, particularly oil. You don't know the pH or stability anymore. So as you can see, the experts have weighed in. This is certainly not a comprehensive list of opinions, but all opinions I could find other than Dr. Dre and Hiram state, do not mix foundation with SPF. It's clear sunscreen is meant to form a film on the face. When you start adding things like foundation, regardless of what its contents are, you're compromising the SPF in an unpredictable way. And let's face it, we're not cosmetic chemists. When it comes to sunscreen, this is a very tricky, finicky product. that you really need to do this kind of work in a lab and have the appropriate tests. Don't mess with SPF. You can mix other skincare stuff, and I do that sometimes, like when I made my own niacinamide cream. But when it comes to sunscreen, let's leave that to the experts. But really, I think this is another example about why we all need to do our due diligence when it comes to heeding the advice of skincare influencers online, whether they're dermatologists, doctors, or even just skincare enthusiasts. The truth is, not everyone has the right answers. There's tons of misinformation out there, and people can be susceptible to that regardless of what their status is or their qualifications. But one thing's for sure, I think that we're all owed an explanation from Dr. Dre, Hyrum, and or L'Oreal as a company. If this research does in fact exist, where's the white paper and why is your customer service center misinformed? Conversely, if there is no study, why are you having influencers promote something that you can't promote on your own site? It's very suspicious and we need answers. That's all I have for today. Use your SPF responsibly. Don't play chemist when it comes to sunscreen, and have fun. Actually, don't have too much fun. Like, don't mix your foundation with your sunscreen. How many times should I say that? But I will say, I will probably make a follow-up video because, spoiler, I do mix foundation into sunscreen sometimes under very specific circumstances. Again, I do not recommend doing this, but under certain circumstances, it might make sense. So I want you to stay tuned if you're interested. Subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so you don't miss that video or my upcoming videos, like the one where I'm gonna talk about myself, I guess. And another spoiler on top of that, I do not use the Dermablend Flawless Creator Drops, and I probably never will. Thanks for watching! I don't like what just happened right there. I'll see you next time.